Okay, I have my big daddy, he's a size 18, flat interlocking hog. Also got some burnt sienna here and some burnt umber, and I'm just going to mainly do burnt sienna with a touch of burnt umber. And I'm just going to cover the whole background. So how is everyone today? I started this painting and there was no sun, so the inverter wasn't making a noise. But now the sun has decided to come out. Just doing the whole background in the burnt sienna burn umber. This brush is losing all its hairs. Okay, we're going to let that dry and then we're going to use a sponge. I have a natural sea sponge. You could use kitchen sponge or any sponge you got. I'm using Cadmium Orange Liquitex Heavy Body Paint. And a sponge, the sponge that I didn't wash previously from a couple years ago, so that's, yeah. But I'm just gonna get some of the cadmium orange. You can use Hue is fine. I just wanted to use this, and this is damp too. I'm just gonna dab it in there, just to get little bits there. Gosh. You get rid of one noise, you get another one. I'm actually going to put out some burnt sienna and a little bit of burnt umber as well, just to mix it up. So there we have the cadmium orange, burnt sienna, burnt umber. And I'm just going to, like, put a little bit of burnt sienna over the top of this. Get some more orange. I hate annoying noises. A little bit of burnt sienna. Burnt sienna, just to mix it in. Burnt umber, burnt sienna. Got cadmium on my finger. Oh! Try it. Try not to get it on your fingers. Apparently it's bad for you. The dragon's gonna be here, so I'm not gonna worry too much about here, but I will put some diox purple down here. I'm just getting some burnt umber and putting it down here. Look at that. The purple is still there. Some dioxazine purple. I want to get some more burnt umber and just make this bit down here just a little bit darker and more mottled. There we go, we had an explosion. Gotta love it when it gets stuck and then it decides to just squirt out. Now I know the dragon's gonna be here, but I'm just gonna put it here just in case some of it pokes through behind the dragon. Orange. Sienna. Made a mess. Sorry. Some more burnt sienna. Okay, I'm just going to leave that to dry and then we'll see what we'll do. Okay, I have my sponge again and I'm just going to do the same thing. Just some more cat orange. Just, oh. Kill the canvas. Because what I want to do with this layer is I want to blend it a little bit with my mop brush. I could just blend it with the sponge. Okay, I've traced the outline and the little niggly bits of the dragon. Okay, I'm going to do my dragon copper. I have Matisse metallic copper here. Filbert size 4, size 4. And I've just got my metallic copper there. And I'm just going to go over him. The base color. Ooh, it's pretty. Okay, here is raw umber and here is burnt sienna, equal parts. I'm just going to mix them together to make the dark tones for the copper dragon. I have my round brush just because it's what I picked up. I don't really have any plans for this one, to be honest. I'm just painting. So I'm going to start down here. These bits here are darker because they go under. just got some titanium white. I just want to go over this again.
Yeah.
Okay, I've got an equal mixture of ultramarine blue and burnt sienna, and it makes this lovely, pretty, gorgeous colour. And I'm just going to go over these dark, spots here because I want them darker. So I'm just doing the second coat. I should have a different brush. Just trying to get these as dark as I can without going black. Yay, there's a fly. I've just killed three. You don't want to go all the way to the end on this end, because you want to leave a little bit of that colour there, copper colour, because the highlight is going to go there. I can hear that. I can hear that fly banging into everything, and he keeps buzzing over here. I'm going to kill him. It's almost winter. The flies should be gone. There he is. I know you saw him, because I saw him. Back to the mid dark tone, which was the burnt sienna and the raw umber mix. Alrighty, for this bit here, I've got some of my metallic copper and my golden gloss glazing liquid, and I'm just going to mix them together to make like a glossy copper. I just want to go over everything that I've painted with the copper again. And I'm getting a bigger brush. Guaranteed I do this every time. Alright, I've got the size 10 flat. That's better. Try and stay inside your lines, like don't go outside the lines. I just want to reinforce the copper colour. He's a copper dragon. No, I had enough glazing liquid on that one. Okay, this part here is one part raw umber to one part burnt sienna, and I mixed it together, and then I put some metallic copper over here, and I just added little bits of this to that just to make the copper a little bit darker, just so that I can go over the shadows again. And make them more coherent now. Blend it in. I'm just going over the darkest bits again. I have some Diox purple and some Mars black, and I'm just gonna dip because I don't want it completely black and I don't want it completely purple. I'm using a round brush here, number 10. It looks like a rhino. Just going to go over this dark shadow here with a little bit of the purple, just so it's not so black. Apologies for all the car noises. I have my garage door open. Okay, to draw down the shadows to make it blend into the light copper, I'm using a mixture of raw umber, burnt sienna, and copper, and I'm just dragging down those black, dark lines that I just put in because they're still a little bit wet, so I'm just dragging it down where the shadows should be. Now I'm going to get titanium white and the copper and mix them together to make a highlight. You don't want it too bright and you don't want it too dull. Try not to cover your dark line, which I just did. I mean, you go back over it, it's simple. This goes on the top of the lines. The top, not the bottom. And surprise, surprise, we have a fly. And as you get further up, the highlight is less and less because he's curled. So he's causing shadow on himself. Did I just do the top or the bottom then? I just did the bottom. And go over that. Using the same copper and white mixture just to go over this again, just so I know where it is. I'm getting the purple and black with Diox purple and the black mixture because this is fairly dark here, this bit. Okay, just going to do the eye bit here. I have some cat orange and I'm just going to put in the base layer for the eye. Okay, we're going to do his horn here, horn. So I've got some copper, and I'm just going to do this very edge here with copper. And then I got some cad yellow light, and I'm going to do a line of yellow light and then line of white. I'm just going to go over them just to blend them in a little bit. I did this bit here, the burnt sienna and the raw umber, and I'm going to do the exact same on this one. So this side here is going to be burnt sienna and raw umber. The next bit is a little bit of cad orange with white. Then the next one is cad yellow light. And then the copper. The teeny tiny little bit of that darker mixture. Just going to do a couple lines in the burnt sienna and raw umber. Alright, for the highlight here, I've got some Cad Orange and Titanium White. Because he has a big highlight here on his cheek. Glazing medium. Just to blend it in. And the main highlight here is going to be Cad Yellow Light with white. And just do that for all the highlights. So this next bit will be Cad Orange with white. And it goes here. And a little bit here. A little bit there. And we go below this line here. All the way to the end. A little bit of the white. So Cad Orange and Titanium White, this bit here. Near the nose. And then Cad Yellow Light and Titanium White for the middle bit. Forgot to do a bit around his nose. This is the darker mixture, the Burnt Sienna and Raw Umber. Okay, I'm just going to do some orange, just a little bit of orange, Cad Orange, on there, and a little bit there, and a little bit more here, and over here, and going down here. The Cad Yellow Light and Titanium White. It's gonna go on top of this bit. Little bit there. Little bit there too. I know he's looking funny, but he has a lot of reflections from the fire that is behind him. The last bit that I'm doing today, because I'm going to kill someone with all these noises, is just black. Or his nostril, because we all need a nostril. I just want to tone down these Cad yellows and oranges a little bit. They're just a little bit too bright. And even though they're that bright on the reference, I don't like them that bright. So I've got some copper and some gloss glazing liquid. And I'm just going over them like we did this bit here. They're just too bright. Too bright for a Saturday morning. Don't go over the eye though, because we want the eye fairly bright. Happier. Not happy, but happier. Okay, I have some burnt umber in a round brush size 10. And I'm just going to go over these dark spots again. And since we've already got the gloss glazing liquid there, it should just, if you just go over it gently, it'll blend in. Because we just want to make sure that this is visible from a distance. Because this is his metallic cheek. I've been watching Westworld. Never seen it before, so I decided to start watching it. I don't know if I really like it or I really don't like it. It's a hard one. It's weird. I still really have no idea what's going on. I'm going to go over this white bit here. This is still the burnt umber. Okay, now this bit down here is darker, so I'm going to get the mixture of the burnt sienna. I'm going to get the mixture of the burnt sienna and the raw umber. That's it there, burnt sienna, raw umber, and I just want to make it a little bit darker. And we're going to have, oops, we're doing this one, aren't we? This down here. Because it's in shadow. And this bit here. And a little bit there. Now I'm going to get some burnt umber and just draw this line that's here. And this one here. I'm going to get the burnt sienna and the raw umber again and just go over all these shadows again. Just building up layers. It's better than just clumping it all on. Just going over the old highlights we did. your lows. Shadows. I entered a painting in the Maryborough show, Fraser Coast agricultural show. Yeah, I didn't win anything. It's kind of disheartening when you see kids walking out with ribbons. And yeah, I've never really entered anything before, and I've never won anything before, so yeah, good times. I'm going to do this bit here with raw burnt umber, sorry. Just because it's fairly dark here. Burnt umber, just to reinforce this line here. And this line here. Using white and copper, metallic copper, just to do the highlight. Need more copper. Highlight on that one, and the highlight on this one. More burnt umber, and we're going to do this bit here because he's cranky. We don't really have that much left to do, just his eye, in details anyway, his eye and his mouth. That was all done in burnt umber. The highlight for this bit here, I'm going to do with the white and the copper again. Make sure you have enough copper in there. Like I said, I'm not sure if I want these cad oranges and yellows here. I know in the picture he has it, and it makes sense with fire and that, but I like the metallic look more. Then the cad look in this one. I love cad, don't get me wrong. I love cad. But the metallic look, it just glows. I love it. More copper and white. And these ones here have a highlight here. And then along with that highlight, you also have a shadow, so there's some burnt umber. More copper and white for this one. Put around here. It's really big. Burnt umber. We can do the top teeth. I'm going to start them in white, just because it makes it easier. Actually, changed my mind, need some copper. As you know, burnt sienna and raw umber. Now white, just to get the base in for the teeth. Gonna do the teeth on the other side as well, so I'm getting some burnt sienna and raw umber. I'm just gonna might get a little bit of burnt umber actually. It's not dark enough. Okay, so they are the teeth on the other side. And now we're going to put an umber. And I'm going back to the white. So I'm going to get burnt sienna and the raw umber, and I'm going to do these gums here. Should start about here. And they go up and down. And they go all the way to there. I'm going to do these teeth in burnt umber. Now the white. Okay, back to these ones. I'm going to put some copper over these. A little bit of white and a little bit of burnt umber. To make the highlights. I love burnt umber. This is just white. I haven't washed my brush, so it's also got burnt umber and copper and that on it. This is copper. Just going over these teeth here. And the burnt umber for the shadows. Burnt umber. Click. Mars black. Teeny tiny bit of white. Some raw umber, just a dot around the bottom to make these gums look more realistic. We just had to wait till we put the teeth in to fix it up or to make it. So I've got some burnt umber and I'm just dotting just to make it well, seem like gums. And then we'll put the highlight back in that we just went over. I'm actually going to make the highlight on these teeth a little bit better. Not so bright. Not so bright. Got some copper and white. Now the burnt umber again. Burnt burnt umber and white for the highlights on these back teeth here. That's too bright. Sticking to the other teeth. So just fix it up with burnt umber. I'm going to do another layer of burnt umber on these teeth here because they're not quite how I want them. Okay, now for the eye. Got burnt umber here, just going to go over this bit. It has a highlight of, I'm going to make it copper and white. This bit here, too bright. Just getting burnt umber to go back over this line here. Might get black. So a little bit of black. This bit right here. Added a little bit of white there, and now I'm just getting the black again. Okay, so we're just zoomed in, and I just put a little bit of black there, a little bit of black there, a little bit of white there, and a little bit of black there, and I'm just going to get a little teeny tiny bit of white, and just put it there. Now we've got some burnt umber. Just gonna do some dibby dabby dots just around here. Now, cad red medium, just the cad red. Just drawing lines, try and make them go curved a little bit because his eyeball is curved. You hope anyway. Okay. Now burnt umber. Not a lot. And I'm going to go cad yellow light. We're just layering the colours in here. Cat Orange. More cat red, medium, or light, you could use light or dark. Rinse my brush off because I don't want to mix the red and the yellow because it will go orange. Cut yellow. Okay, now the burnt umber towards the outside of the eye. It's going to go over his pupil. Pointy, make that all black. Got distracted, sorry. Just fixing something up. Okay, some more burnt umber. We're going to do another bit here. Might put a little teeny tiny bit of black in there. And then, as usual, burn umber and white, just for another highlight. And we lost that one, so I'll go back over it. And some more burn umber. Black. Oops, I just spat. And might do some more cad yellow, no, more cad orange. Just here. Now I need some more red. Because I did too much orange. And then we want just pure white. Highlight there. And a bigger one there. And they join. Don't ask me why. We want this bit here to be shining. Here to be shiny. And a bit here. Okay, let's do his nose. I've still got the white there that I just had. Getting black. I don't want to get black, but I think I need it here. That's still black. Now I'm going to get some white. I still have the black on me. Still the black on here, so it's not going to be too bright. She says as it's fairly bright. Go over that with a little bit of copper. And these horns are fairly bright right here. And halfway down. We lost this highlight. This is copper and white. I just did a little bit there. Now I might do some more white on these teeth. I've still got the copper on my paintbrush, so it'll be coming through. burnt umber again, just about over this line here that we lost. I might even change that to black. And this one here. He's looking pretty good. Burnt umber. And a little bit of black. Get some white, and with whatever I already had on my brush, I didn't wash it. And some more white again. I just want to go over this bit again. Okay, now for some final highlights down here. We're working down here. Put some copper over the top of that one. I want a highlight there, but not so bright. And these edges down here will be a mixture of copper and white. It won't be just the bright white. Surprise, surprise, we have a fly. And a little bit of copper and white just to go in between these bits here. And unless I've forgotten something, which I don't think I have. That's it. There he is, Mr. Angry Metallic Dragon.